We live in a world where both old and new mysteries abound, and now we are taking a significant step with science to unravel these mysteries. Today, we will try to understand how quantum computers, a very powerful type of computer, may be connected to events that many people remember differently. That is, the Mandela Effect. The Mandela Effect is the phenomenon where a large number of people remember an event or detail differently from how it actually occurred or from what is recorded in historical documents and other sources. This collective misremembering can cover a wide range of topics, including quotes from movies, details of historical events, brand names, and even the existence or characteristics of certain geographical locations. One well-known example is the belief that Nelson Mandela died in prison in the 1980s, despite being released in 1990 and passing away in 2013. This widespread false memory has actually given the phenomenon its name. Other common examples include people remembering the Berenstain Bears children's book series as Berenstain Bears, or a specific line from the movie Star Wars as Luke, I am your father, whereas the actual line is No, I am your father. Quantum computers operate much faster than normal computers, and according to some scientists, these computers could connect us with worlds unknown to us. Thus, the reason we experience the Mandela Effect could be due to these computers interacting with other realities. To better understand this, we will continue to explore the connection between quantum computers and the Mandela Effect. We will push the boundaries of knowledge and perhaps learn new things about the universe and our place in it. We are just at the starting point of learning much more on this journey. Stay with us on this exciting journey towards the unknown, and let's search together for questions about how reality works. The causes of the Mandela Effect are still debated. Some explanations are based on psychological and social sciences, and suggest that false memories can be formed through a combination of factors such as misinformation, social reinforcement, and the way human memory works. Memory is not a perfect record of events. It can be influenced by later information, which can lead to changes in how we remember past events. From a more speculative perspective, thinkers and theorists have linked the Mandela Effect to theories about parallel universes or alternative realities. According to this view, differences in collective memory may stem from the merging of parallel worlds or the movement of individuals between these worlds, leading to discrepancies in memory. However, this explanation is considered a fringe theory and lacks experimental support. The connection between the Mandela Effect and parallel universes seems to bridge science fiction and reality. This connection continues to remain one of the biggest mysteries of our time. The theory of parallel universes suggests that the universe consists not only of the reality we live in, but also of an infinite number of alternative realities. Associating this theory with the Mandela Effect appears as an attempt to explain why some people remember the same event or detail in different ways. For example, the misremembering of Darth Vader's line in the Star Wars movie series as, "No, I am your father," "Luke, I am your father," or the Berenstain Bears children's book series name being misremembered as Berenstain, are popular examples of this theory. Such collective misremembrances could be leaks from a different parallel universe. These leaks could occur as a result of briefly merging with or experiencing elements of an alternative reality at a certain point. Expanding on the examples, people misremembering the Febreze brand name with only one E as Febreze, or people remembering the Monopoly Man with a monocle in the Monopoly game, are among the interesting examples of this theory. If the theory of parallel universes is valid, then these minor differences might be traces of conditions from an alternative reality that have seeped into our reality. Although this theory is certainly exciting and stimulates our imagination, critics point out that such connections have not been scientifically proven and that claims of this nature go beyond speculation. Indeed, the relationship between the theory of parallel universes and the Mandela Effect remains for now more of a thought experiment or a subject for philosophical discussion than a hypothesis that can be proven with scientific methodology. If we were to examine the topic more closely in a technical sense, we have a timeline, and any event occurs within this timeline, such as the case we previously mentioned, where the Monopoly game character has a monocle. In an alternative reality, the scenario is that he does not have a monocle. Situations like this can be expanded with different examples. These are instances where different people collectively remember the same incorrect thing. As the timeline in the main universe progresses, a significant event occurs that triggers a change in reality. This event is a large-scale quantum effect observed to cause the formation of parallel universes and symmetry breaking. For instance, running quantum computers at an effective level or operating the Hadron Collider at CERN are such impactful events. Here, a break occurs. We jump to a parallel reality. And as we proceed in this parallel reality, the moment of breakage in the previous universe aligns in phase or overlaps with the moment in the other parallel universe, continuing as a new reality. We are unaware of this. Our memories are not affected. But when we look, reality has changed. And with this changed reality, inconsistencies in memory occur. We remember the events of the previous universe, but in the newly formed alternative reality, these events exist in a changed form. Our story begins with a discovery at the heart of D-Wave quantum computers, which exploit the strange principles of quantum mechanics to operate. These are not just computers. They might be our first real windows into parallel dimensions, offering a glimpse of what lies beyond our current understanding of physics. The marvel of quantum computing lies at its core, the concept of the qubit. Unlike traditional bits, which process information in a linear, binary fashion, qubits exist in a state of superposition, allowing them to process vast amounts of information simultaneously. This capability could be key to unlocking the doors to parallel universes, turning quantum computers from mere computing tools into instruments of exploration. You might ask, what does this have to do with the Mandela effect? Imagine a world where every choice branches off towards a new reality. Now imagine a machine powerful enough to influence which branch we find ourselves on. The Mandela effect, with its collective misrememberings, could be evidence of these machines at work, adeptly altering the flow of our reality or merging timelines. Beyond mere computation, the potential of quantum computing extends to the realm of augmenting reality. These machines could simulate the entire universe, offer us experiences indistinguishable from our reality, and even blur the line between what happened and what could have happened by altering our perception of historical events. Quantum computers and the qubits at their heart rank among the most striking discoveries in modern physics and computer science. How can this technology be related to theories on the existence of parallel universes? The answer lies in the fundamental principles of quantum mechanics and the unique properties of qubits. A qubit, or quantum bit, is the fundamental building block of quantum computers. Unlike bits used in traditional computers, a qubit can simultaneously hold both 0 and 1 values. This characteristic is known as superposition and makes qubits incredibly powerful. The superposition of two states allows qubits to perform multiple calculations in a single operation. This theoretically makes quantum computers much faster and more efficient than traditional computers when compared. The association of quantum computers with parallel universes stems from another fascinating feature of quantum mechanics: entanglement. Quantum entanglement is a phenomenon where two qubits become so interconnected that the state of one can instantly affect the state of the other. This interaction can occur faster than light and is not dependent on physical distance. This feature has led to the idea that quantum computers could pull information from parallel universes or perform computations across multiple realities. Imagine, for example, a robot trying to find its way out of a maze. A traditional computer would attempt to find the exit by trying each path one by one. However, a robot controlled by a quantum computer, thanks to superposition, could explore all paths of the maze simultaneously, reaching the exit much more quickly. By leveraging the properties of superposition and entanglement, quantum computers could simulate potential outcomes of events across different time periods. This offers a kind of time travel experience, allowing for an understanding of how changes made in the past could affect the future. The theoretical connections between quantum computers and parallel universes have the potential not only to revolutionize our understanding of our universe, but also to possibly acknowledge the existence of multiple universes. The development of quantum computers could one day turn these speculative ideas into reality and open new doors in unraveling the secrets of the universe. The issue lies in the speculative link between parallel universes and the Mandela Effect, where a significant number of people remember events or details differently from the documented reality. Why does this speculative link exist? It exists because the Mandela Effect involves inconsistencies in collective memory that cannot be easily explained by current scientific understanding or traditional memory theories. Why are current scientific understandings or traditional memory theories insufficient? They fall short because human memory is complex and not fully understood. These theories primarily focus on individual memory errors, social influences, and misinformation, but do not account for the widespread and collective misremembering of specific details. Why is the complexity of human memory not fully explained in these theories? The complexity of human memory is not fully explained because memory research is challenging. It involves psychological, neurological, and social components interacting in unpredictable ways. Additionally, the subjective nature of memory and the lack of comprehensive models that bring all these elements together make it difficult to fully understand how memory works. As we conclude this journey into the unknown, we are left with more questions than answers. The interaction between quantum computing and the Mandela Effect opens Pandora's box of philosophical inquiry about reality, memory, and the potential of technology to reshape our world. Advancements in quantum computing, heralded by visionary scientists and engineers like Geordie Rose and Seth Lloyd, promise a future filled with untold possibilities. Machines that can look into the multiverse not only promise a technological revolution, but also have the potential to profoundly transform our understanding of existence itself. We have only scratched the surface of what might be possible on this journey. As we stand on the brink of discovery, we invite you to contemplate infinity, question the nature of reality, and imagine a future where the impossible becomes possible. Join us in exploring, questioning, and marveling at the mysteries of the universe. For in the pursuit of the unknown, we find not just answers, but more questions, fueling our endless quest for knowledge. Thanks for listening. Stay well.